Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's now see how the propagation steps of a radical reaction accomplish the overall reaction. At the top of the screen is our overall reaction. Below that overall reaction are two reactions, which together are the propagation stage for our overall reaction. Note one of our starting materials for the first propagation step is a radical. This is one of the radicals we formed in the initiation step in the previous video. All propagation steps will contain a radical. So first, we need to have the initiation step to form radicals so that we have a radical to do the propagation step. Remember that we said propagation steps result in zero net change in the number of radicals. Both propagation steps start with one radical and end with one radical. When these steps occur, there is no net change in the number of radicals. That is always true for propagation reactions. This is a mock reaction, but we can still write some mechanisms. In the first step, to get to the product, we need to form a new AC bond and break a CD bond. In a radical reaction, we use Fish-Hook arrows. And here is the mechanism for this reaction. The movement of each electron is shown. Note that the first step forms a new radical, D dot. We then begin the second step with this same radical. Again, this is a mock reaction, but let's show the mechanism. We need to break an AB bond and form a BD bond. Here is that mechanism. Note that we finish with a new A radical. This radical will go off into the reaction, collide with another molecule of CD, and perform the first propagation step again. These steps will repeat over and over again until you run out of AB or CD. The propagation steps accomplish the overall reaction. If we've written them properly, we can add the two reactions together and get the net reaction. So if we add these together, we can cancel species that appear on both sides of the arrows. That means we can cancel the A radical, which appears as both the starter material and product. We can also cancel the D radical. What falls out of this addition is the same as our overall reaction. The propagation steps should collectively provide the net reaction. So that is the propagation stage. The propagation stage includes multiple reaction steps that A, do not cause any change in radical concentration, and B, perform the overall chemical reaction.